They pump out a brand new BMW every 61.7 seconds. Every 61.7, it's about 450,000 a year, round about. You don't understand. You all see that plant. It is something to behold. By the way, these plants are not carrying toolboxes anymore. They carry laptop computers. There's no grease on the floor. They got robots. It is something to see, and they pay good money. But if I were someplace, if I were a company like that, that's the biggest plant in the world, is in South Carolina. In the world, including Germany. So why would they come here? They look at our research universities, which USC, Clemson, and Carolina agree. They work together, they collaborate. And that's the way of the future, is collaboration and communication and brain power. That's what I see. But if those universities will collaborate, they'll then enter into agreements with these companies where they join forces to take us off into new discoveries and innovations that we're not even thinking about today. On the corner of Blossom and Assembly Street in Columbia University has a building that's got, University of South Carolina has an IBM, that big blue IBM sign on. What are they doing there? Among other things, what they're doing there, they've gotten some software recently from Siemens, which is a huge company, $624 million in top of the line aeronautical engineering and other such things, software. What else do they have there? IBM has a national data analytics headquarters there. What else is in there? There's a new software package called Watson. Anybody read about that? It can figure anything out. And they are working together, IBM, Siemens, and the University of South Carolina. And y'all, they're off the scale. It's hard to listen to them and understand what they're talking about. But every time they invent something new or come up with a new process and combine, there are all kind of entrepreneurial activities and opportunities and new jobs will be coming in, and that's what they do. IBM has, in Watson, they have what they call predictive analytics. They can look at a vehicle, they can look at a tire, they can look at all these kind of railroad parts, even washing machine parts, they can look at it and they can study it through data, and they can tell you when the parts go off or wear out in advance, so you can fix it, replace it before it breaks. And what else are they going to do? This is something brand new. They can do it. I asked the man, can you do that to the human body and tell me when something's going to wear out? He said, yes. What they did, they studied cancer. And they took data from a whole lot of people to determine what was going to happen. That is, what would be the course of cancer and what could be done. And they compared two things. The results that were predicted by Watson and the results that were predicted by the top group of cancer specialists in the country or something equivalent to that. And Watson came out with 30% of the predictability. Now they just begin in this. What's that mean for us? That means things are happening. And they're happening right here. And that means there'll be more and more jobs, more and more people working. So jobs come in, they got to build buildings, same thing with these big plants, or automobiles, tires, those kind of jobs. You got to have buildings, you got to have houses, you got to have roads, you got to have all the kind of stuff that people work on and get hurt. It's not libraries, artists, these are people that are out there working with their bodies and their brains, building things to support that kind of growth. So that's one thing there. Our technical college system is another one that brings them in. Nobody in the country, nobody in the world has a technical college system like we do. I didn't know that until just a few years ago. And I've been learning more about it lately. We have something called Ready SC, started in 1961. So we're way ahead of these other states. 1961, what we will do today is if you go in, say, Sweden, and you have a plan, you're building something, you're thinking about coming to South Carolina or someplace else, we can send a team of experts there in manufacturing that can go to your plant in Sweden, as in Paul, as in BMW, as in all these places. We'll send them that. They can analyze the customs, the habits of the workers, the people. They can analyze the machines that are necessary, what it takes to build them, what you have to do to work. They can come back and put together a group of people at our technical college system. We put the word out all around the state. We got 16 locations for technical colleges, and find people that want to come to the technical college and get an associate's degree, whatever they, the curriculum that they set up to support that particular plan. And we do. And I talked to the executives, and they said, that is the most important thing in that area that there is for us. Nobody else in the country does that. And we're the only ones. So that is highly important. You know what the cost is? Zero to the company. Nobody can touch that. What else? The other Charleston is deep. It's getting as wide. It's getting ready to go deeper. We got the money. It's come to put up the money a couple of years ago, and just recently we got a little bit more. The Corps of Engineers start dredging this month, October. What's that mean? That means when it's through those big boats that are now going through the new Panama Canal, that used to not come to the Atlantic coast because it had to go all the way around South America. They're going to be coming through the canal and coming up the Atlantic coast. And the two dominant ports in the United States, they say before long, will be Port of New York, New Jersey, doing the same thing, and the Port of Charleston. And it gives a new tutorial for you. You spell port M-O-N-E-Y. That's how it's spelled. In addition to having that deep, wide port where those ships can come in, they carry 13 or 14,000 of those container units. You see, can you imagine that? I'm one of these days, I'm going to go count them. I just have a hard time imagining we can get that many on one ship. But they do. We also have two inland ports. That is a railroad line running up through Greer and across 85, which means the drivers can come in, drop the load there, they don't have to go to Charleston and come back, and the reverse is equally true. That saves 400 miles of driving, that's time, that's money. Also, we just broke ground on one in Dillon County. It goes across 95, same thing. So here we have a magnificent deep water port with two inland ports to supplement the flow of the goods, the logistics. It's just fantastic. And then put on top of that, Watson and IBM figuring out where the right routes are around the world and figure out what's happening with the weather and all that. I mean, it's something like the space age. But that ain't even all. We got the lowest union participation in the United States. We've got, we have the right to work law, we have the right to work attitude, we've got plenty of power. Y'all know we stumbled a little bit with the bankruptcy of Westinghouse, but we're working on that, and on that process, which is at the request of the companies that are coming to take a look, I've said we're willing to consider selling this antique company as a state-owned power company. We sell it as long as the state, we don't have to ask our companies. Just have to go through the board and the legislature. But, so they're coming in, and we've had people, companies from all over the place, some that you haven't even heard of, that want to come to South Carolina, who want to get a park, get a foothold, get involved in more and more expanding business in South Carolina, and they're looking at that. And I'm hopeful that we have a perfect storm of different circumstances, we may be able to come out a lot better than we actually may in. And then you have the weather. But here's the final one. They always tell us that the main thing is the people. All these other things are very important. The tax structure is very important. A good court system is very important. A good workers' compensation, a reliable workers' compensation system is very important. We've had, I remember years ago, Walmart wouldn't set up a plant in a facility in South Carolina because they were scared you would get sued by some of the lawyers in South Carolina. We've come here for years. We don't want to be outliers like that. We have to be good, we have to be reliable, and workers' compensation forms such an important part of that. But that's one thing we look at as well. And law enforcement. We want to know about law enforcement. But the main thing they always say is surprised me somewhat, all of my suspecting, is the people. And I heard the chairman of BMW say that a few weeks ago up in Spartanburg at the 25th anniversary of BMW. And heard one of the top people in Walmart say that GT Tire up in Chester, they would produce, I think, I can't remember how many thousands. Mississippi, same thing. They said, South Carolina is a handshake state. Said, if someone in South Carolina gives you their word, they'll keep it. And they said, it's the only place we've ever been where that is true. Said, most of the work that the planners and the executives and others at GT, for example, and these other places, said, we're done on handshake. The local, development groups and the county officials and the state officials said, yes, we'll do it. And they took that word and they went ahead and most of the stuff is later written in the contract. But y'all, we're different. And we are, that is, spells great things for the future of this state. Those of you from another state, there are great advantages to your state as well. But I have not seen one yet that has all of these things that I mentioned. Most states don't even have an ocean, as you know. Ain't nothing we can do about that. Great weather, and yeah, this is one place you can be at the beach in the morning, and you can be in the foot of the Blue Ridge in the evening and see all kind of beautiful stuff as you drive up. You can't do that everywhere. So that's why they're coming here. And the reason those kind of businesses, that kind of activity, creates more and more work for all kinds of people. And right now, we have 60,000 people, the HVAC, truck drivers, carpenters, electricians, plumbers, all those that are absolutely necessary in building the infrastructure to support this kind of growth. We have 60,000 of them, 60,000 jobs out there that are looking for those people. It's rare in our history that we have jobs looking for people. Usually have people looking for jobs, but it's reversed now. So we're working on apprenticeship programs through the technical colleges and the universities to build that kind of workforce. But it's going to keep on going. And so you are going to be a place to make an important impact on what's going to happen in the future of the state. Because if all of these parts don't fit together, then we could lose the momentum and the reputation that we have now for being the best place in the country to do business. So we got to keep the taxes low and get them lower. North Carolina just lowered theirs. And that's a big economic incentive. We have to be very careful if we don't tax the people and the businesses too much. I'm going to tell you, a lower and lower, broader tax base ends up good. President Reagan calls bringing in more money, but people actually pay less. The economy grows, they want people working. But his final point, a few years ago, I was meeting with a group in Columbia in the Capitol City Club. That's one of the top one of the buildings. And we were looking out there, and I was talking to Christy Todd Whitman, who'd been the governor of New Jersey for 8 years, and recently, at that time, been head of the EPA for a number of years. And we were looking out across the Green Rim, we see the Conquery and the Saloon, and the Broad River, and all the greenery, and they were just beautiful. Blue skies and the State House right down there, and gorgeous, and you can see the USC campus. And I commented that we really do have it all here. We're going right straight to the top. She said, yes, you do, unless you mess it up. Well, I'm determined not to mess it up. I'm determined to make this thing go, because we have to increase our competitive advantage, or these companies will go somewhere else. And it's like planting a tree. You get this company, before you know it, it's just bigger and bigger. All sorts of fruit falls off of that. Pardon me from the voice. But that is, I see, is that a style I'm going. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have an expanding economy with good jobs and people are happy and they're getting up to go to work, what happens? Domestic violence goes down, drug usage goes down, crime goes down, divorces go down, marriages go up. If there's one thing that can fix everything, other than anything else, that said, is an expanding economy. So you're right in the middle of it, and I appreciate you inviting me here. I look forward to seeing you later.